I don't fall for this world title. I done defended it, defended it again. And that green belt just looks so nice. It just looks so nice. It looks like steak. I gotta have it.
Where did this barking come from? How long have you been doing that barking? Just man, natural?
My boxing name is K-9. You must have watched The Contender.
I know.
So when the dog comes, so does the bark. But for others, don't bark if you can't bite. See what the shirt say. Yeah, I made it famous, so I'm on The Contender Season 2. Big shout out to Sugar Ray Leonard, Sylvester Stallone, everybody from The Contender, all the fighters. You know, we still doing it, baby. Like I said, the first should be last, and the last should be first. I was the last one picked in the schoolyard pick, and I was the first one to win. I was the first one to become world champion out of my season. The dog is coming.
What do you expect different from Corey in this rematch?
I think he's going to try to be slicker. I mean, you know, I went out there and just threw bombs at him. And I just went out there really, I really fought reckless. I mean, you know, I thank God that I even won that fight the way I won it, because I went out there and just, you know, threw bombs from everywhere. I think you're going to get a chance to see that I got more than just bombs. You know, I got skills, you know what I mean? I guess knocking somebody out is a skill too. But you're going to see a lot more improvement. You know, a lot more. My last two fights have been against southpaws. Mm-hmm. I mean, I beat the guy I lost my first fight to, which was a huge victory for me, my last fight, June 25th against Fu Pao. I beat Corey Spinks, who was a southpaw. And, I'm just happy, man. I wanted to say something, but I don't want to say it.
Okay, but you said you went that last fight. You just came in throwing a lot of bombs. Is that a byproduct of fighting in St. Louis? You felt like you needed to come in and just throw bombs and just...
Man, I think the Holy Spirit took over me, because I didn't even train to fight like that.
Really?
No, I didn't train to fight like that. But I just knew that I didn't want him to get comfortable. I said, the heck with some throwing some jabs and try to, you know, outbox him. He was in there comfortable. I didn't want the crowd to start getting behind him and start saying, Corey. Once they start saying Corey, I wanted everything to be gone from him. That's why I took it to him early. So when they did start chanting his name, well, nothing he could do. He couldn't get that home crowd advantage. Like when the Pistons play and the Pistons are down and you hear the crowd go, yeah, Pistons, defense. You know, I wanted them legs to be gone. I wanted their mind to be gone. I wanted everything to be gone. So once they started chanting that and saying that, it was over with. You know, nothing he could do about it.
But obviously the dynamics for this fight is going to be different. So we're going to see a different K-9 from you.
Oh, yeah. You know, well, I mean, every fight, but my last 3-4 fights, I've been training like a madman. This fight, I train like even more of a madman. I mean, I'm in the best shape of my life. And ain't nothing he's going to be able to do to stop me from getting a victory. And I come in here, you know, with God first, you know, Jesus for life. And, I mean, you know, I'm real determined. I'm real focused. And you're getting a lot out of me right now because, you know, my juices are going. I just got them, you know, sweating a little bit. But you know, other than that, I would be kind of calm. But, you know, he got what he wanted. Yeah. You got to get my good side, man. You know what I'm saying? You got to get over here, man. You know what I'm saying?
That's why we got our cameras right
see,
here.
They see,
side.
They see the tooth like this. They think this came from boxing. Little kids, this came from not taking care of my teeth. Take care of your teeth. This didn't come from boxing.
You know, in hockey, if a player loses a tooth, he doesn't fix it. It's like a badge of honor.
Oh, yeah. But, you know, this didn't come from boxing. If it was from boxing, then I probably wouldn't get it fixed. But I got to get my smile back, man. I should have had, since it's on Showtime, I should have had somebody, you know what I'm saying, to sponsor me. Like, you know, yeah, do your teeth good, you know. But, you know, that's okay. But after this fight, though, you know, definitely I want to unify the belt. So I want to fight Canelo. I mean, and I think that, to be honest with you, I think that it's been spoken by God, because I mean I didn't pray that that Paul Williams fell, and I wish that didn't happen. And I don't want to get a fight home done like that, but that happened.
Yeah,
you know, and they was talking about me and him fighting, you know, but that happened. Then Kirkland turned down $1 million. Yeah. That happened. Then Ortiz, he gets his jaw broke. But I think it was meant for me and Canelo to fight. Mm-hmm. Nah, we're going to find out come tomorrow. I mean, come Saturday, we're going to find out. But I think God already spoken that, hey, it's going to be Cornelius K-9 Bungers and Canelo Alvarez, September the 15th. And it makes sense. You know, people don't want to sit there and say, oh, K-9, well, I was on The Contender. Do you know I was watched by 2.5 million people per week? Mm-hmm. I went to UK. Mm-hmm. I can't believe it. Now, I'm a kid, didn't graduate. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, I went to UK and they was going, K-9. I felt like Michael Jackson. I started to do break dance and everything. I have a big following, way bigger following than they can imagine. Once, see, the contender, I brought a lot of fans to the boxing from the contender. Mm-hmm. A lot of people that watched the contender only watched the reality show and liked the boxing because I was on it, because of the reality show, because of the But they probably don't even know that I'm still boxing. They don't even probably know, half of them even know I'm a world champion. Once they promote that fight and say, we got K-9 from the contender, he's a world champion, they're going to say, what? Huh? The UK is coming. Germany is coming. Detroit is in the house. St. Louis loved me. When I went out there and took that, they said, hey, you know, Corey Spicy from, but hey, you did what you had to do. So St. Louis got my back. Nope. California, I done fought in California 5, 6, 7 times. Mm-hmm. This is my home. This is a home for me. And God said we can go wherever we want to go. So wherever I go, as long as all you gotta do is put a ring there, put a referee in there, mm-hmm. and show me the check. And the opponent, I'm gonna chew him up. But God is great though, man. God is great, y'all. You know, I just like to have fun, man. It's about having fun, and you know, boxing is fun to me. 39 is the new 24. You know, they keep on talking about somebody. K-9, he's 39. Don't believe that. I told Corey Spinks and Corey Spinks crowd or one of his trainers or someone, we was in there fighting. And he was like, he's tired, Corey, he's tired. I said, Don't believe that. 39 is not, I'm not 39, but I'm 39. Don't believe that. Yeah. Trickery, real trickery. Well, what's his name? Copperfield or something?
Yeah.
Man, real. But you know, I ain't saw that match stuff, but I'm trickery. I'm the N1 of boxing. The N1, you know, N1 of Harlem Globetrotters.
Yeah. Yeah.
You never know what to expect. I didn't expect that I was gonna fight Corey Spinks like that the first time. Mm-hmm. And I expect to fight him differently this time, but who knows, I might go out there and bulldog him again. But I'm gonna let the spirit lead me though, you know? Yeah, but it's been nice talking to y'all, man, and I see that smile you got, man, you know. And what's your nationality? You Japanese?
No, I'm Chinese.
You're Chinese, okay. Yeah. You smile, you can't see your eyes. That's cute. That's cute though. That's cute. All these southpaws on fight, you never know. Down the line I might fight one of your boys. I know who you're going for.
Oh really?
Pac-Man. I used to tear Pac-Man up though. The video game.
You know, I get that all the time. When I was in Vegas, I get that all the time. I went to cover Bradley and everybody kept looking at me going, Pacquiao, Pacquiao.
Yeah.
I'm like, no, I'm covering the other guy.
Oh, okay. Pacquiao's a good fighter though, man, and you know, I'm happy with how he, you know, gave up a lot of things for God. That was good, man, you know, and it was kind of sad to see that fight, you know what I mean? Because, you know, I like Bradley too, though. Me and Bradley, we cool, so, but, I mean, you know, it's just, you just can't leave it to the judges, you know what I mean? You just can't. I don't go into no fight trying to leave nothing to the judges, to be honest with you. You may see me go out there and box, but eventually the dog is coming. You know, I might go out there and box a little bit, but, you know, even with boxing, I'm trying to take him out. Believe me. Forget that. If I can get paid for 40 seconds, now who you know? I mean, not a lot of people can make $100,000 in 40 seconds. Mike Tyson made $25 million in 90 seconds when he beat Michael Spinks. That's a lot of money. Am I wrong?
That's a lot of money.
That's a lot of money, man. And I was trying to get my money fast. Not the dope dealing way. Nah, that's old with, you know. I'm talking about fast. The faster the better. Man, what a bank at? You know what I'm saying? Oh, they need to have an ATM machine right next to my corner after the fight. I could just forget the check. Just give me my money now, you know. But yeah, man, you know, I'm just happy, excited to be on a good card like this. And then we got two guys on a card, and Gary Russell Jr., who's a good fighter.